Kill67 Gaming. We are back again with another generation challenge. This is the sports games that we're playing. And we are doing, this is number...
Seven.
Round seven. And the current score is...
3-2, you're winning.
Right, so this time we're going to be playing... What is it we're playing?
Brian Lara International Cricket 2005 for the original Xbox.
There you go then. We're going to try and make it as short as possible because cricket does go on forever. So we'll play six overs, is that?
Yes.
What we're playing? So we'll play six overs and whoever scores the most wins. Seems straightforward enough. Who are you going to be?
England.
I think I'll be South Africa. So anyway, we'll get to it. See who comes out on top and speak to you afterwards.
Welcome, cricket fans, to a match that's got all the right ingredients for some really closely fought competitive cricket. A gorgeous summer's day here, the crowd all suitably dressed, ready for watching a day of cricket in the sun. The lorries made the long climb up to the commentary box. You had a close look at the pitch earlier, Bill. How did it look?
Well, Jonathan. When I walked the pitch earlier, there was only one place to be, batting. It's hard and flat and really a batsman's paradox. There should be a lot of runs in it, and the bowlers will have to work hard to get anything out of this pitch. It might begin to crack towards the end of the match, which will help the spinners. But until then, it's really truly a boots time for the batsman. I want my captain to win the toss and bat so I can put my feet up in the pavilion.
Two picked up there.
Themselves in the right mess there and paid the price.
The new man in can't afford any lapses in concentration here. No runs there. Two more picked up. Gone.
Out first ball. You might just as well have stayed in the changing room.
Let's have a look at the action replay. I'm sure the new batsman will look to play himself in. Six runs come from the over then. The seamer to start a new over then. Through the gap, and that'll go for four. He's certainly not hanging around. That was a very confident shot. He picked the length really early there. Two picked up there. That's 15 off the over. No run taken off that ball. No runs off that delivery. No runs there. Nothing scored there. That's out.
That was a lazy shot. He'll get that when he sees the replay.
Let's have a look at the action replay. New batsman at the crease. Wide ball signaled by the umpire. He certainly tested the keeper out with that one. Two from the over. They're going to try and liven up the attack here. No run taken off that ball. Thank you.
You can't afford to lose wickets like that in top class cricket.
A left hander at the crease now. One more under the score. Another single. Three off that over. He didn't play that one very well. When assessing a batsman's technique, how important is basic stance?
Well, once I thought it was very important, but I think when you look at the modern players, some have their bat in the air, some play square on, some play side. That's just throwing away wickets. The captain will not be very pleased about that.
Serious pressure on the new man in there. Say makes a really top class fast bowler then, Bill?
First of all, he's got to have courage. I think it's a tough job, day in and day out charging. Wow, he certainly wasn't out in the middle for very long.
So, New South African batsman on strike. Impressive bowling there.
You can't afford to lose wickets like that in top class cricket.
With the left hander on strike. Another over gone. So, this is the final over. Big appeal. The umpire isn't having any of it. Nothing scored there. Scoreboard. So, Bill, having played for some of the great Aussie test sides, just how good is the current Australian team?
Well, it ranks with the greats. I was only a young lad in the 48 team, the Invincibles. My father talked about the Invincibles with Graham and Hassett, Linville and all that. And then came Ian Chappell's teams of the 70 with William Thompson. But certainly, for all-round ability in both times of cricket, I don't think there's been a better side than Australia. So a better group of players, at least. We've never had a group of, say, 18 players of this quality ever.
The fielder hardly had a chance to move. Over so far. That's been given it a wide. Much too early on the shot. Him. Let's have a look at the action replay.
That was an absolute aberration. What was he thinking? That's the end of the South African innings. The opening batsmen have a vital job. Their goal must be to see off the opening bowlers.
That wasn't far away from the edge of the bat.
All that effort and you give away runs plus, you have to bowl another delivery.
Well, what's the umpire going to say about this one? Gone.
It seems like miles back to the pavilion when you've got out cheaply.
Let's have a look at that from another angle. New batsman on strike for a minute.
Well held by the fielder. That took a long time to come down.
And from another angle. So, left hand, right hand pairing of course now. Got him!
That was a lazy shot. He'll get that when he sees the replay.
Let's have a look at that in slow motion. He's getting a polite round of applause as he makes his way to the pavilion. So, it's a left-right combination of the piece now. Chance goes down. That's a stroke of luck for the batsman.
That really is not good cricket.
That was an excellent. That nearly joined us in the commentary box.
Dreadful judgment by the two batsmen. That's throwing wickets away.
New batsman on strike for England. 10 taken off the over. Fast bowler to start a new over. Confident appeal. The umpire shakes his head. The batsman was absolutely bamboozled by that one. No run there.
Terrible call. He didn't have a hope of making it.
New batsman in. The great Bill O'Reilly was a supreme leg spinner, but do you think he was better than Shane Warne? Or does Warne stand out as the greatest leg spinner of all time?
Well, that's an unfair question, I think. It's very difficult to say. The people before the war know Lindsay Hassett, the great Australian captain and batsman, rated Bill O'Reilly as the best bowler of all time. Modern batsmen would probably rate Shane Warne. So, from my point of view,
Umpire signalling a no ball. He played all round it. That is a superb delivery. Let's have a look at that from another angle. Let's have a look at the innings so far. Absolute concentration required from the new man in. That's good bowling.
Great bowling. The batsman misjudged it completely. That was an absolute aberration. What was he thinking?
Into the tail now. Well, what's the umpire going to say about this one? And the umpire's killing it.
He's back in the pavilion without troubling the scorers.
Let's have a look at that again. Let's have a look at the scorecard. Plenty of pressure on the new batsman. End of another over. A slow bowler to start a new spell. They're having a shout. No response from the umpire. That's well bowled by the left armour. He's dropped. Another chance goes begging.
The fielding team really cannot afford to score chances like that. Super shot. He got right into perfect position for that shot. Head over the ball, wait forward.
The crowd really enjoyed that one.
Smashing shot, really smashing. I'd pay money just to come and see that.
That really was wonderful timing. He's gone for it, and he gets six. He took the aerial route, but it paid off. And we have a change of bowling. He played all round it. That was right out of the top draw. Let's have a look at that in slow motion. Serious pressure on him, man. Oh, that's close. The umpire isn't having any of it. No run scored. The bat was all over the place with that one. No runs there. We've beaten all ends up by that one. There is one for a duck.
Certainly not the longest innings ever, and certainly not the highest score in the world.
This is how the innings ended. It's all over.
Well, we had a little bit of technical difficulties there with the capturing software. It was not playing with the Xbox, so we did just do a cam on the screen for that. So if the quality isn't brilliant, then that's why.
It seems as if the score will be 4-2.
4-2.
You obviously winning.
I don't know. I thought when people played cricket that they scored hundreds and hundreds. We weren't scoring hundreds and hundreds, were we?
Can I just point out this was actually my second time playing a cricket game, though?
Well, I don't think you did badly, did you?
That kind of explains my actions.
Well, as you said, it is 4-2, so we're going to go into the next one. Oh, going to the next one, I'll have a chance to win.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
And I'm not looking forward to that.
If you haven't already,
go say like, share, and subscribe.
And we'll see you next time.